1 and looking to bounce back from a loss last week. In week 4, the Cowboys lost to the breezeless Saints in New Orleans 12-10 as their sputtering offense only managed 257 total yards. But Dak Prescott still was high on his squad.
When you walk around this locker room, and I think I said it when we were 3-0 or whatever, this team's not really, we can't focus on that. We know the potential of this team. We know how good we can be, and we can't focus necessarily on what the record is. You take the good, you take the bad, you live and learn from it, and you get better because of it. So everybody's just been in with the mindset of getting better, however we can.
We now welcome in Louis Riddick. So nice to see you in person.
Yeah, it is good to be here.
Yes. What's up, Smooth? What's up, Smooth? You know what I'm saying? I had to tweet this morning about the Get Up crew.
All of them look like
they're trying to audition for Chippendales or something. What the hell's going
on? Trying to be comfortable.
I'm just saying.
You know what I mean?
You have on a tan, too.
Apparently, I'm the only one who came dressed for work.
Let me tell you something right now.
I
went outside. I went outside. 2 days ago, we outside in New York City. It was 93 degrees.
Yeah.
Yesterday, man, I go outside, damn near 50. Yeah. I'm like, what's going on? That's why my throat
got the turtleneck
stretching.
And the corduroy.
Oh, hell yeah. I'm like, the nuts cold. Winter, summer old. Summer's old.
Yeah.
Summer's old.
You gotta dress in layers.
I'm freezing. I'm serious.
All right,
let's go.
Perhaps Dak has to heat it up for Dallas, all right? Because he's the leader of their offense. Stephen A., how important is it for Dak to have a big game Sunday?
Believe it or not, I think it will be. Because obviously, you know, the perception is that Green Bay having the 26th ranked defense against the run. Look, they've been suspect against the run, get the ball in Ezekiel Elliott, coming off an 18 carry for 35-yard performance, didn't even average 2 yards a carry against the Saints. He took it personal, according to all the reports. He's going to be gung-ho about going up against Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers, at least that defense, all right? We understand that. But here's what we're not anticipating and what we're not expecting. Dak Prescott to make noise against the third-ranked defense against the pass in Green Bay thus far for the first quarter of the season. And so because of that, you're on your home turf, you in Dallas, still don't have your contract, still get paid $2 million while everybody around you get paid in the 30s, all right? You got $2 million, you after your money, everybody's expecting to revert back to the run, at least for this particular game, because it's Green Bay coming up who's proven this suspect against the run, particularly over the last couple of weeks. And so when you look at it from that perspective, if you're Dak Prescott at Jerry World on your home turf, even with Dallas Cowboy fans questioning whether or not you're the guy to lead them to the promised land because your passing game is suspect in their eyes, because the first time this season you went against a real team as opposed to the Giants without Daniel Jones, Washington being Washington, the Miami Dolphins, the resident Pop Warner team of the NFL. The first time you went against a real NFL team in New Orleans, you Dak Prescott, you got shut down and all you could do was generate 10 points. You show up against Aaron Rodgers on your home turf, knowing Aaron Rodgers on the opposite side of the field, knowing Green Bay's a third-ranked team against the pass, and you show out, it puts you in a good position.
I agree it does. Of course, it's better for Dak and the Cowboys if he is a superstar against the Packers, but he doesn't need to be. Well, they have such a good team, and Green Bay is, listen, the Eagles really exposed. They have a problem running the ball. They have a problem stopping the run. That is a fundamental problem if you're a football team. I don't care what era we're talking about, passing, whatever. Lewis can talk about this better than I can, obviously, but you got to be able to run the ball and stop the run on some level, right? So, but let's say they load up against the run because this is so clear what's going to happen, right? And they're somewhat effective. Dak will have to hit some strikes down the field, of course, but he could end the game with something like one touchdown, no interceptions, 236 yards through the air, and they can win this game. Mm-hmm. Because Ezekiel Elliott can punch one or two in. Because they can kick a couple of field goals. Because the defense could score some points, right? And all of a sudden you look and you go, because Green Bay, it's more of the same. Aaron Rodgers has decent but not great offensive weapons around him. Mm-hmm. He has a defense that's gotten better in the secondary but is flawed. And he has to be perfect plus in order to overcome great teams. Where all Dak has to do, and it's not a dirty word, is game manage and be big on third down. And if he does that, which he's done most throughout most of his career, they can win the game.
Look, I mean, there's two different things going on here. There's what's good for Dak, what's good for the Cowboys.
Well said.
Now I'm talking about what's good for Dak.
Exactly. See, because
can you break down what's good for
Dak? Well, what's good for Dak would be, okay, look, remember this in this game too now. He probably going to be missing both of his offensive tackles. Going up against two guys who are rushing the pass are pretty good in Za'Darius and Preston Smith for the Packers. So it would be good for Dak to say, hey, look, I have Michael Gallup back. I have my running game that's probably going to average somewhere above 4, 4.5 yards per clip against this defense that can't stop the run. So I'm going to utilize play action. I'm going to sneak up underneath here between these guards and center, I'm going to let my backup offensive tackles run these guys wide, and I'm going to dish this football. And I'm going to cut up this defense, and then I'm going to lean on Zeke, and then I'm going to cut them up a little bit more, and I'm going to use the fact that they can't stop the run to set up my play action pass, and I'm going to have a big game, and we're going to win the game, because then I'm going to have people shut their mouth about the fact that I'm just a game manager. Mm-hmm. I'm just a guy who deserves in the mid-20s as opposed to $35, $40 million per year. That's what would be good for Dak. For Dallas, this is about winning the game. Mm-hmm. Just win the football game against a team that's going to be there in the end, no matter how flawed they are, because Aaron's going to keep them there in the end.
It's amazing.
So that's what he needs to do for himself. And I think he can do that within the context of still doing what's good for the team if he does it the way it was just laid out.
So you anticipate a big game for Dak?
I absolutely do, for a number of different reasons, because I think it just sets up that way. Mm-hmm. And look, I don't care what he says or anyone else says who says they don't listen to us, they don't read the paper. They listen to us and they read the paper.
That's right.
And they care about it all because Dak wants to be respected as well as paid.
Well, right. So I call Tom Brady a game manager now. Like, he's going to leave the lead the way he came in. That happens to a lot of great quarterbacks. Happened to Peyton Manning at the end. People take such offense to that idea. But if you're Dak Prescott at this moment of your career, I think he's likely to get paid. He's likely to get his money.
Yeah.
What's wrong with doing what Tom Brady and Russell Wilson both did early, which was rely on a great defense and parts around you, manage the game, and be big when your team needs you to be? To me, that seems like it'll not only get him paid, it could win Dallas the Super Bowl.
That's because people don't like that perception. People just don't like that label put on them as saying, when you say game manager, that means I can't elevate everyone else. I have to have everyone else around me in order for me to be successful. See, people right now, especially quarterbacks want to be looked at the same way people look at Pat. Right.
Well, good Mahomes, luck with that.
Which is this. You know what I'm saying, though?
He's a gunslinger.
But that's how people want that.
But let me tell you why your point is very, very profound when it comes to Dak. When we saw Dak as a rookie, what was his shining moment? The Dallas Cowboys against the Green Bay Packers.
Playoffs.
Mm-hmm. Dallas is trailing 21-3. Dak Prescott brings them back, and they tie the score at 28. Dak Prescott throws for over 300 yards in that game. He throws for 3 touchdowns in that game. And we said, whoa, this brother is going to be special, because on a big stage with a playoff berth on the line, with Aaron Rodgers on the opposite side of the field, he went tit for tat with Aaron Rodgers, and it took Aaron Rodgers scrambling out of the pocket the way Russell Westbrook did last night, running to his left.
Yeah.
Russell Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
Russell Wilson ran to his left before throwing that dime into the corner to lock it. Aaron Rodgers scrambled to his left and threw that sideline.
So that
pass.
Said.
I'm saying that's what you're looking
so,
for.
So that said,
that's
do
what
you think? I love the way that sets up. So, in other words, Dak has that thing, guys, you know, rally the troops, don't get down on yourself, brought them all the way back, and they would have won that game if they weren't facing, at that point, the best quarterback I'd ever seen, making a play that, until Patrick Mahomes came along, only he could
and
make.
And we're saying he has to remind it.
Dak now has to beat that?
No,
he needs
no,
to
no,
top
no, no,
Aaron
no,
Rodgers?
No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is he has to remind everybody of that moment. And this is the perfect opportunity because it's the same guy. It's still Aaron Rodgers on the opposite side of the field. It's the same guy. You remind and the same stadium. You remind them of what we remembered most that made us say, excuse me, we need to look at this brother and watch
what we
him.
Remembered is, Dak, you're great, but you ain't Aaron Rodgers.
There's two different things at work here. There's what's good for Dak, what's good for the Cowboys, and if you can have them both happen at the same time,
right.
Now you really are elevating yourself into the discussion of, do you belong with the elites? Because if you can be, even though he doesn't play against Aaron,
right.
And they're not, if he beats him and he puts up 300 and throws for 3 touchdowns,
he balls.
He's gonna shut a lot of people up. He's going to have the people in his own front office going,
if you're Green Bay, what are you going to do? You're going to stack the deck. You're going to stack the line. You're going to say, we ain't letting Ezekiel Elliott.
Oh, no question.
Dak Prescott, show us what you got.
But all you got to do is loosen him up a little.
I'm just saying.
All you got to do is hit a few.
But again, it's not a matter of what he can do or what he has. Remind folks of who you are.
It sets up perfect for him.
And all eyes will
because
be
of what
on
he just
Dak.
Said.
Now, we got to go to break.
Yeah, yeah.
You're sticking around with us. All right, so we'll have you back. All right, still to come.
Notice you got the shirt. You
know, Patrick Mahomes.
Oh, I ain't going nowhere. I'm cool.
Patrick Chippendale.
Chippendale.
Doing these quarterbacks.
I'm still Chippendale. I don't know what these guys talking about. What?
Yeah, he started that. He started that mess this morning.
About his former teammate, Jimmy Butler. Plus, struggles in the passing game have caused a lot of tension in Minnesota, and you don't want to miss what Stephen A. and Max say on how they would fix the problem.